C-Mac, and I am the one.
C-Mac to the rack! Here's Mcgrady off the drive. Tracy Mcgrady has got 50.
He's the best one-on-one player in all league.
Mcgrady, what a move.
That's the hardest guy to guard.
It's Mcgrady, look out!
He's the best small forward in the league.
Oh, baby, what a play by T-Mac!
I am a versatile player, a guy that can go inside, outside. It's how you want it. I tell him, how you want it, man? I can give it to you any kind of way, so how do you want it?
Look out. Unbelievable. He's smiling himself there.
For Tracy Mcgrady, being an NBA superstar wasn't just a dream. It seemed to be his destiny.
I think I was just born with natural talent.
T-Mac won the NBA scoring title in 2003, the league's youngest scoring champion in nearly 30 years. And he can put up points in every conceivable.
Just don't have a specific move.
A spectacular move, and his ability to hang in the air.
It all depends on how my defender is playing. I might can shake him one way and go the other.
When he starts to go, he just keeps going.
And pull up for a jumper.
Mcgrady absolutely on fire.
Well, I might just take him all the way to the rack. You really never know.
Tracy was drafted by the Toronto Raptors in 1997, going from high school right to the NBA. As a rookie, his playing time was limited, but his talent was clear.
The two-handed jam. Tracy Mcgrady is putting on a show here.
When the Raptors drafted Vince Carter the following season, he needed no introduction to T-Mac. The two were cousins. And though Vince was older, Tracy was the one providing guidance about the NBA.
It makes my transition easier. I mean, city life, game time, practice, anything that's new to me, I just come to him.
Carter to Mcgrady. It's a family affair.
Emerging as the league's newest sensation, Carter quickly took center stage, while Mcgrady took a supporting role. One that brought mixed feelings.
The good part about it was I was learning from him and watch how he handled being in the spotlight every night. The bad part about it is he always took the game when it shots.
They're going to Carter.
And I sometimes wanted to be in his position.
Vince Carter with 1.6 gets Toronto a two-point lead.
But it was no jealousy at all. You know, I had to pay my dues because I was still young. You know, I just had patience.
Tracy's patience would pay off in 2000 when he signed with the Orlando Magic. Finally, it was his turn to be the leading man, and he would show the league that he was more than ready for his opportunity.
Well, he has certainly stepped up his offensive game. Look at him wheel to the hoop. Beautiful wraparound, powerful move by the NBA scoring leader.
Hey, we got to take care of the ball, man. We got to. Come on.
He's spectacular! 57 points for Mcgrady!
You're missing too many layups.
You're right, I got dunked it. I like the move. Finish!
You're right.
Finish!
Mcgrady sets a franchise record 62. Mcgrady, he is full of life tonight.
Oh, that's a big one there, T-Mac.
By age 24, Mcgrady was already a four-time All-Star and one of the NBA's premier players, rising beyond even his own expectations.
I felt like I can be an all-star if I just got somewhere and showcase my skills. But I didn't think it was going to happen this quick.
Tracy Mcgrady going glass.
Man, I think I might wear a headband.
Whoa.
No.
So we
on camera.
Oh.
These days, Tracy has joined Vince Carter in the bright glare of the NBA spotlight. It's allowed him to show his fans a personality that can be just as entertaining as his game.
Thanks.
All right, thank you.
Oh
my God.
It really means a lot to me. You know, without the fans, I won't be who I am today.
Tracy Mcgrady Show.
I definitely needed a haircut right there.
We're doing a little special, so you gotta wave at my boys right there. Hey, the camera, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, right there, on the floor.
On the floor right here?
Yeah.
Tracy has had the chance to blossom not far from his roots. His hometown of Auburndale, Florida, is just 40 miles down the road from Orlando. And though it may be close in distance, T-Mac has come a long way.
That used to be my crib. That's where I grew up at. Right there, man. That is the house that I grew up in. The neighborhood that I grew up in, it wasn't the best. But this home made me really just look back and really see what I come from. And just realize that I'm blessed.
In some ways, it seems as if Tracy has never left the old neighborhood, a place where no one knew him as T-Mac, NBA superstar.
I don't know where T-Mac came from, because we grew up calling him Punkin.
He'd rather for me to call him Punkin instead of Tracy.
Punkinhead, baked beans.
He loved baked beans. He used to love baked beans with sugar on them, so a lot of people out here call him baked beans.
You know what I'm This is home, man. I mean, I love my town. I just hang out. I don't try to hide myself from these people.
A lot of people, you know, they're, you know, come from a small town, and, you know, some of them won't look back at the town, but Trace is one of the ones that always remember where he come from.
Now Tracy is focused on what's ahead. He's proven his individual brilliance, but playoff success has eluded him, and his competitive fire burns more fiercely than ever.
I'm trying to do whatever it takes to get to that next level. I just don't want to be known as a guy that was a great player, but he didn't win. I want to be known as a champion. I want to win, man. That's the only thing I want to do. Winning is everything to me.